Liberals foul out to trash Trump backfires after they mocked victims of NYC terror attack in it. Ever since Trump got into office, we've seen the disturbing lengths that liberals will go to in order to have him removed as president. Assassination threats and disgusting attacks on Trump's family are now a daily occurrence, as rabid leaders within the Democratic Party continue to call on their minions to violently resist Trump by whatever means necessary. As liberals' antics are now reaching a fever pitch with the assassination attempt on Congressman Scalise over the summer, they've now thrown their disgusting rhetoric into high gear with a disgusting political ad they made to depict all Trump supporters as massacring terrorists. One of the left's favorite narratives to spew is that Trump and his supporters are all minority-hating bigots who only want heightened immigration processes implemented in order to keep black and brown people from moving to America. Despite the fact that ISIS terrorists have managed to gain a substantial foothold in our country because of our weak vetting process when it comes to immigration, liberals still idiotically want to fight to bring more of these people in, while demonizing anyone who disagrees with their reckless immigration stance as a bigots and racists. As the state of Virginia's race for governor is underway, nasty liberals decided to take out a disgusting political ad on GOP gubernatorial hopeful Ed Gillespie, where they depicted the Republican as a racist who is mowing down children of color while he's driving a jacked-up truck that's waving a Confederate flag. Zero. Shares. Facebook. Twitter. Ever since Trump got into office, we've seen the disturbing lengths that liberals will go to in order to have him removed as president. Assassination threats and disgusting attacks on Trump's family are now a daily occurrence, as rabid leaders within the Democratic Party continue to call on their minions to violently resist Trump by whatever means necessary. As liberals' antics are now reaching a fever pitch with the assassination attempt on Congressman Scalise over the summer, they've now thrown their disgusting rhetoric into high gear with a disgusting political ad they made to depict all Trump supporters as massacring terrorists. One of the left's favorite narratives to spew is that Trump and his supporters are all minority-hating bigots who only want heightened immigration processes implemented in order to keep black and brown people from moving to America. Despite the fact that ISIS terrorists have managed to gain a substantial foothold in our country because of our weak vetting process when it comes to immigration, liberals still idiotically want to fight to bring more of these people in, while demonizing anyone who disagrees with their reckless immigration stance as a bigots and racists. As the state of Virginia's race for governor is underway, nasty liberals decided to take out a disgusting political ad on GOP gubernatorial hopeful Ed Gillespie, where they depicted the Republican as a racist who is mowing down children of color while he's driving a jacked-up truck that's waving a Confederate flag. Fox News reported that in the wake of the New York incident on Tuesday night where a Muslim psychopath rammed his rented vehicle into cyclists and joggers, the ad was quietly removed, as liberals quickly realized what heartless hacks they'd be viewed as if the commercial aired on television. "We knew our ad would ruffle feathers. We held a mirror up to the Republican Party, and they don't like what they see. We have decided to pull our ad at this time," said Christabel J. Alex, president of the LVF, in a statement on Twitter Tuesday evening. "Given recent events, we will be placing other powerful ads into rotation that highlight the reasons we need to elect progressive leaders in Virginia." The statement was released just hours after investigators said the suspected driver, identified as 29-year-old Saiflo Saipov, plowed a rented pickup truck into a crowd in Lower Manhattan. The incident, being treated as a terror attack, left at least 8 dead and at least 11 others injured. The ad was released on Monday and was expected to run through Election Day. Gillespie denounced the ad Tuesday morning in an interview with Fox and Friends. "This attack is not just an attack on my supporters, it's an attack on all Virginians. The fact is, whether you disagree with people or not, in Virginia, we respect civil discourse and this is a new low in politics here. It's a sad day," Gillespie said. In a statement to Fox News, Gillespie's campaign manager called the ad a desperate smear campaign. "The nasty and divisive rhetoric of the left truly knows no bounds. Could you imagine the backlash if someone ran a political ad on Barack Obama, where he was mowing down Christian children as a way to make a point about his radical ties to ISIS and Islam? The Daily Mail pointed out that the ad was also targeted patriotic Americans who routinely use the Gadsden Don't Tread on Me emblem to show their sentiments about those wishing to take away American freedom. The Daily Mail reported. The political ad showed a white driver behind the wheel of a Chevy truck, which was decorated with a Gillespie for Governor decal and a Don't Tread on Me sticker, a sign of Tea Party support. The truck also featured an oversized Confederate flag. One child is heard yelling run, 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 as a number of non-white kids, including a girl wearing an Islamic headscarf, take off as the truck revs. Before it hits them, however, the children wake up safe in their beds, as the ad asks Virginia voters to reject hate. Even before the terror attack, the White House on Tuesday was particularly incensed by the ad. Frankly, the only people I see stoking political racism right now are the people in the groups that are running ads like the one you saw take place in Virginia earlier this week, Press Secretary Sarah Huckabee Sanders said at Tuesday's press briefing. How utterly vile. Yet again, the nasty rhetoric of the left is blowing up in their America-hating faces.